Hi, I'm Mike, and this is TYT Science. Now, today I'm going to take a leaf out of Professor Rich's book and push away from the data and information and just rant freely about an issue that's important to me. If you don't know who Professor Rich is, please look up TYT history videos and get yourself a scholarly education on political issues of the day put into historical context. Now, my rant is about anti-science in America. First up, just because I say anti in America in the same sentence does not, by any stretch of the imagination, make me anti-American. In fact, what I'm trying to do here is show my support for those American scientists and other Americans who I know to be frustrated by this issue. By anti-science, I mean that body of people that directly has hostile views of science, scientific endeavor, scientific results, and scientists as a body of people. And this is something that throughout all of the Western world you only really see in one place, and that is the red states of America, and often associated with Christianity, usually associated with Christianity, which is not to paint all Christians in that bracket or even all of the Republican Party in that bracket, but that's where you see it happening. Now, there are three reasons for this. The first reason is obviously religious. There's a belief that science aims to undermine the scriptures. Secondly is socio-political one, which is essentially, it's well known in America that the vast majority of scientists are social, liberal, progressive by political orientation, and so that automatically makes them the enemies of some people. But furthermore, there's a suspicion that they are abusing their privileged position to manipulate data to pursue their liberal agenda. Now let's deal with those two first, okay? Science and religion. Science is not inherently anti-religious. Science just does its own thing, and that is to measure and test the measurable and testable world and try and explain it as best you can and build models of the world that have predictive power. Now, sure, when you push back from that and compare it with what's taught by an extremely literal interpretation of the Bible, you will in some places find a clash. Sorry. Point number two, the socio-political aspect. Now, although scientists may be of any political persuasion, the truth and the nature of the world is inherently not political. And it is the job of scientists to pull out the truth and the inherent nature of the world. That is their job. That's what they got to do. They certainly take it very seriously. Now, if you have a political agenda and you want to bend data or be fraudulent in any way, could you do it? Well, sure, you could, but generally speaking, it wouldn't last very long, because unless you're in cahoots with absolutely everyone, then other people who are investigating similar things independently are going to find that their data clashes with yours, and furthermore, if they're trying to build findings based on what you've claimed, they will find that they fall through. So generally speaking, it's a pretty maladaptive strategy and it doesn't really come off. Now, this leads me into a third reason, which is very undiscussed and can best be illustrated by a recent YouTube discussion I had. There was a video claiming to prove that dinosaurs never existed because someone phoned into a radio station to say that no dinosaur skulls had ever been found until last year. One of the comments was, there's a skull in my local museum, to which the answer was it was a sculpture, to which I chipped in, well, if you go to Google Images and search for dinosaur fossils, you'll see tons of bones, including skulls there, and that is a hell of a lot of sculpting for scientists to get involved in order to be fundamentally very unscientific for God knows what profit. And I have, in my personal experience as a scientist, never come across anyone who I believe would ever engage in such behavior, let alone seeing it on a mass scale. To which the answer was, what a load of bullshit you just wrote, something, 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 funded by tax dollars, something, something, thanks, Mr. Science Comedian, did you get paid to write that? Now, my objection here is actually to the funded by tax dollars bit, because I've seen that crop up in various cases, and this completes the negative image portrayed by some of the scientists, which is, firstly, they are against God and seeking to educate your children against God. Secondly, they're all liberals who are essentially corrupt and pushing a liberal agenda. And thirdly, to add financial injury to the insult, they're doing all of this with your hard-earned tax dollars. Okay, they're living off your money. Now, this pisses me off. And let me explain why. This fundamental portrayal of the roles of the private sector and the public sector is actually not unique to debate in America. I've seen it in the UK, I've seen it elsewhere. And there's some really misguided thinking going on. Let me explain. When a scientist gets their salary, what happens to it? Now, they're not in the top 1%. They don't have lots and lots and lots of it to stash away, to hoard up. No, they pay a proportion in taxes back to the public system to support teachers, police. The rest of it, what do? They spend it. They buy clothes, they buy food, they buy stuff for their house, right? It goes straight back into the private sector. So they get money from the private sector and they spend it back in the private sector. And in the meantime, they do a lot of very good work. And this is true of all of the public sector. Okay? They get money from the private sector and they spend it back into the private sector, and in the meantime, what do? They provide the basic infrastructure of the country in terms of legal system, policing, education, safety, transport, oftentimes health, and also a vast body of knowledge, all of which creates an environment in which individuals and enterprise can thrive. And with scientists, you get a particularly good deal, because generally speaking, you get very intellectual individuals, some of the best brains in the world, who are also very moral, very passionate, prepared to work super hard on moderate incomes just for, as Richard Feynman said, the joy of finding things out and building up a big database of knowledge that, bar some global catastrophe, will be with humanity for the rest of its existence. That's what we do.